In the fifth today, it's time to take a look at a small amplifier of Fosse Audio. So this amplifier, as you can see, it's pretty compact, as big as your hand. And the funny thing is, it has this like Huey meter, which does work and triggers with the volume, of course, and with the power output. And you also have like a bass and treble adjustment. So in the past, amplifiers were pretty big, pretty bulky, but these days, these amplifiers are much smaller than the speakers they are powering. So to showcase how powerful even this small amplifier is, I have pretty big drivers of Savonska brand, which is a sub-brand of Yamo. And even though this is a small amplifier, those big speakers punch out a lot of power. So because of limitation of my microphone, I will not use them on like max power or anything, but I will use them on around 80%, 70% volume of this amplifier. So I can already say that the audio this is performing is pretty solid audio. Its Bluetooth is normal Bluetooth codec, which means that you don't have like any high-res audio possibilities, even though Bluetooth has always been a bit of a gimmick on its side. But do keep in mind, this one has the normal Bluetooth codec, which is pretty fine for Spotify, but yeah, if you use Tidal, for example, or you make your own music with a higher bitrate, it will be more compressed with the normal Bluetooth. But you can also use wired audio. So it has the RCA possibility to put audio in. And then of course you just have whatever you sending to the speakers. So without further ado, here are those audio samples so you guys can see how they're performing with this amplifier. Again, these audio samples are a bit of a mixed bag experience because microphones, even though my microphone is pretty solid, you will never have the real experience. So yeah, keep that in mind. Let's get started. This amplifier, it works pretty solid. it is a pretty powerful setup. And of course this external power adapter, which is included with this amplifier, is pretty bulky, so it is, I would say, about 4 times this phone. The amplifier itself has been pretty much compact. So the overall audio experience has been pretty solid, and especially if you don't put it like above 90% volume, which the amp does have some limitations, the audio performance is very solid. Even my pretty big speakers of above 175 watts, I believe, of rated power, they work perfect on this small amplifier. So it's pretty cool how powerful this small packaging is. The only complaint I could have with this amplifier is that it has no remote control, so you can't do anything with like on distance. So for example, volume control, you have to do it on amplifier itself, which is a bit of a manual control. Of course with Bluetooth you can of course adjust the volume on your phone separately, but do keep in mind if you put the amplifier on like 70% volume and your phone on 20%, it still will try to give a powerful sound out of the amplifier. So I do prefer to use volume control on amplifiers because of that reason. So the funny thing with this amplifier is that even though this Fury meter is a bit of a gimmick, it does give this a bit cooler look than some other generic amplifiers, also from this brand itself. Again, it's just a bit sad they don't use like Bluetooth aptx and maybe an optical possibility to connect to this amplifier, because the RCA, even though it is still a solid solution for wired audio, optical is something that is more and more known. Even HDMI ARC is more known, for example with the Volcano speakers, the ARC lineup. So I did hope they could at least put something like optical on it, so it's also more usable for a TV solution, for example. HDMI ARC is a bit of a gimmick maybe for stereo, but it could also be pretty useful, because then even though it doesn't have a remote, then the volume could be controlled with like a built-in chip with HDMI ARC. Again, it's a pretty cool amplifier for simplified audio listening. It's just a bit limited on functionalities. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I know this setup is changing every time, but hey, I'm trying to find a way to make these videos a bit better every time. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Be sure to be subscribed, because I do see a lot of people not being subscribed or being offline for somehow reason. And see you in the next one.